Trees. They're everywhere in nature, but they're also common in your data, such as your company's hierarchy or your family tree. But when you store these hierarchies in your database, it can be hard to tell where each row fits in the tree. Luckily, all you need is a bit of SQL magic to turn your rows into a tree. It's your dear old grandma's birthday coming up. To celebrate, you want to draw out a family tree for her, showing all her children, your parents' aunts and uncles, their children, you, your siblings and cousins, their children, and so on. To help with this, you've got details of all your family members stored in a database table. But run a standard query against this, and it's not obvious which generation each person belongs to and who their parents are. You can get around this by joining the table to itself, over and over and over again for each new generation. But this is a pain to write, and if you want to redraw your family tree starting with your great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandma, you've got to rewrite your SQL query. You can overcome these problems using hierarchical operators. But before we dive into the SQL, some terminology. In the real world, a tree starts with roots and grows out to its leaves. A data tree is the same. The starting points are the roots, the ends, the leaves. Each point in between is a node. And, like a family tree, the direct ancestor of a node is its parent, and its direct descendants its children. A root is a node with no parent, and a leaf is one with no children. Back to the SQL. To write your query, you need to know how to identify which rows are the roots and which columns contain the relationships between parents and children. Your grandma is the start of the tree, so she's the root. And the relationship between parents and children is just like in real life. The mother or father of each person is the parent of that child. Armed with this information, you can now start to write your SQL query in Oracle Database. But first, you need to choose between the proprietary connect by clause or the anti-compatible recursive with. In both cases, you want to begin with the root, your grandma. With connect by, select her in the start with clause. Using with, you have a normal select to get this row. As in real life, each person's parent is their mother or father from the previous generation. So you need to check these columns against the family member from the previous level. Using Oracle syntax, you can access this with the keyword prior. So in the connect by clause, you need to check if the prior person matches the current mother or father. Recursive with is more complicated. You need to union all the subquery with the initial query to fetch your granny. Then join this back to the original family table where the person from the subquery matches the mother or father. At this point, both methods have built your tree, but the results look like you've just selected from the table. It's not obvious which rows are the children, grandchildren, or great-grandchildren. To show this, you need to add in which generation each person belongs to and indent the rows appropriately. With connect by, this is easy. The pseudo column level shows which position you are in the hierarchy. This starts at 1 and then increments for each new set of children in the tree. So, granny is at level 1, your parents, aunts and uncles level 2, you, your siblings and cousins are level 3, and so on. You can then use this to pad spaces before the names so you can easily see who is in each generation. Recursive with doesn't have a level function built in, but this is easy enough to do manually. Just select 1 as the level in the base query. Then, in the recursive part, increment the level and add spaces before the names. Now it's easy to see which generation each person belongs to, but the order may be a bit jumbled. Usually, you want to sort siblings from oldest to youngest and show all a person's children next to them in the tree. And it's here that recursive with has a big advantage over connect by. You can specify how you want to walk down the tree, depth first or breadth first. With depth first search, you start at the root, then keep going all the way down until you hit a leaf. You then go back up until you find a node with a child you've not visited before, follow that down until you find the next leaf, and so on. So you're always going down as far as you can. On the other hand, breadth first search visits all nodes at the same level before going down to the next. So it starts with your granny, then gets all her children, your parents, aunts and uncles, then all their children, and so on. This search type can affect how quickly the SQL runs or even how the query works, but for now it allows you to specify how to sort your results. To show eldest children first, immediately followed by their children, you want depth first search ordered by birth date. Doing this using recursive with is as easy as sticking this after the subquery. You also need to define a column showing which order the database visits the rows. This goes in the set clause. To guarantee you display the rows in this sequence, place this column in your order by. Sadly, connect by doesn't have an option to specify how you want to search the tree. Displays rows in the order it accesses them. Adding an order by destroys this sequence. Luckily, order by has a siblings clause, which allows you to specify which order to show rows in the same generation. So to get the same effect, order siblings by birth date. So now you've built your family tree showing all your granny's blood descendants. But real family trees usually include both parents of every child. Trying to do this adds a lot of complexity to your SQL. For example, if you try and add grandpa in as a root, you build your whole family tree twice, duplicating everyone else in the family. This is because in data terms, each node in a tree has at most one parent. But of course, in real life, everyone has two parents. So a family tree isn't a real tree. It's a directed isolate graph. Bear this in mind if you're trying to draw out family trees using SQL. You're best off following the descendants down one gender, for example the mothers, then joining the fathers in as appropriate. So now we built your family tree, but there's still one important aspect of trees we need to cover off. Loops. Unless we discover time travel, it's impossible to be your own ancestor. So you can't have a loop in a family tree, but they are possible in other data structures. If a loop does exist in your hierarchy, as you walk along it, you'll eventually get stuck in an infinite loop. Luckily, the database can detect these and stop the query. Unluckily, it will error out when it does, leaving you with no results. You can avoid this problem using cycle detection. With connect by, just add the no cycle keyword after connect by, and Oracle database will bail out if it comes back to the same row. Doing the same using anti-style is more typing, but also has more power. For example, say you've arranged your bricks in a tree with largest at the top and smallest at the bottom, but you've accidentally pointed one of the leaves back to another branch in the tree. There's no loops, but this node has two parents. So, as you walk down the tree, you'll reach it twice, meaning you'll get two copies of all these bricks in your results, something you want to avoid. You know bricks get smaller as you go down the tree. So, if you've seen a brick of the same size you've seen on the path so far, you've got a problem. The cycle clause allows you to detect this and stop processing. To use the cycle clause, list the columns you want to check for duplicates. Then, define a new column with the value to set when the database sees a repeated value, and a default if it doesn't. So, that was a quick overview of how to build hierarchies using SQL. There are also a host of functions you can use with connect by to find things like which rows are the leaves or the ancestors of a row, and so on. Check the links in the description for more details on these and how to emulate these functions using recursive with. Just remember, when building trees, watch out for loops and make sure you define the roots. Otherwise, you'll build a new tree for every row in your table. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this and want to watch more SQL videos, click the links on screen now.